Hello, in this video, I'll be talking about trastuzumab and pertuzumab. Which one is better and how do we know what to give? Before I go on, I'd love to encourage you and invite you to subscribe to this channel. We put out new content, fresh content all the time, so there's always something new to watch. I'd also love to encourage you to go to yerbba.com to see if trastuzumab and pertuzumab might be part of your treatment plan. So both pertuzumab and trastuzumab affect the HER2 receptor. The HER2 receptor is present on 20 to 25% of breast cancer tumors and will determine a lot about your treatment course. In somebody who has HER2 positive breast cancer, trastuzumab is almost always part of their treatment plan. Pertuzumab and trastuzumab are actually used together. In people who get trastuzumab, they may get pertuzumab as well, depending on the stage and severity of the disease. So how do these drugs work? Well, the HER2 protein is something that is, like I said, present in 20 to 25% of breast cancers. And these are targeted monoclonal antibody. It's a single clone of antibodies made in the lab, and these drugs affect that tumor protein, which then affects the cells and makes them die. It has a bad effect on the cells. And these drugs have been game changers. Until these drugs became available, HER2 positive breast cancer was associated with a worse outcome. And now, because of these two drugs, trastuzumab and pertuzumab, the outcome is pretty much the same as if the tumor were HER2 negative. So, of course, it means you're getting these drugs, and we don't want to give or get more drugs than we need to. But that aside, because we have these drugs, we now see people with HER2 positive breast cancer living as long as they would have if their cancer were HER2 negative. So these are real game changers. They've revolutionized medicine. I do want to share that I had a patient who was the first patient in New York to get trastuzumab when it first came out and was available only to people on a clinical trial. So I've seen firsthand how these drugs affect outcomes and have changed breast cancer care. So these drugs are given intravenously. Trastuzumab can also be given under the skin in people where getting an IV is really difficult. But they're not given orally, they're not taken as pills. They go through the whole body, through the vein, or trastuzumab can go under the skin. I will tell you the situations in which we use these, not just the tumor types, but the other characteristics. In people, I'm gonna start with advanced or metastatic disease. In people with advanced or metastatic disease, trastuzumab and pertuzumab are superior to trastuzumab alone. It's better to get both than it is to get just trastuzumab. Now that is given, these are given with a chemotherapy drug called docetaxel, the brand name of which is Taxotere, in the Cleopatra study. We name studies a lot with these acronyms, and all the title, the words of the drugs in the study began with the letters Cleopatra. So the Cleopatra study looked at people getting docetaxel for advanced breast cancer with trastuzumab versus people getting docetaxel with trastuzumab and pertuzumab, and pertuzumab added to the trastuzumab made the whole regimen better. So in the advanced cancer setting, the two are better given together if it's tolerated. I'll go into side effects in a moment. It's really important to know the side effects and also the impact that can have on your treatment options. Now, in the non-metastatic setting, we give trastuzumab in people getting chemotherapy after surgery, or we can give trastuzumab with chemotherapy before surgery. And we now add pertuzumab to people getting chemotherapy and trastuzumab before surgery. I know this is a lot. I'm hoping that the captions are helping. Let me back up. You have HER2 positive breast cancer. You're getting chemotherapy before surgery. If your tumor's HER2 positive, we'll add trastuzumab and pertuzumab. What if you're getting chemotherapy and trastuzumab after surgery? For people who have high enough stage disease, pertuzumab is often added to trastuzumab. So when I said which one's better, it's kind of a trick question because they're usually given together. Now, sometimes we'll start with one and add the other, or sometimes we'll start with both and drop one. When we drop a drug, it's usually pertuzumab. So let me tell you about the side effects. With any of these monoclonal antibodies, we can have an immune reaction to them. We see them as foreign, and the way we react is like an allergic reaction. We're having a reaction to a foreign substance, and we can get flushing and shortness of breath and a higher heart rate. Our blood pressure can fall. We can get all kinds of skin and cardiovascular reactions. Those happen with the infusion. While you're sitting there getting the drug into your vein, you can have one of those reactions. It usually happens very quickly after the medicine is started. Your treatment team knows exactly what to do. They will stop the drug, they will check your blood pressure, they will give you additional medicines to help you tolerate it, and then fairly soon after, they will restart it because you are more likely to get through it if it's restarted quickly, not an hour or two later. So it will be restarted. A few people can never take one or both of these medications. Some people just have an immune allergic reaction that's so great they can't be on these types of medicine, but that's pretty uncommon. Most people can restart and complete their treatment, and it usually happens the first or second time you get the treatment. With trastuzumab, we do worry over time about heart problems, and so if you're on trastuzumab, you will be getting an echocardiogram or a test called a MUGA test every few months to make sure your heart is holding up just fine. If it's not, we usually stop the trastuzumab and manage the heart problems, and sometimes trastuzumab can be restarted. With pertuzumab, very rarely do people have heart problems. More often we have rash and diarrhea. That diarrhea, rash, and actually fatigue that come with it can be so pronounced people just can't take pertuzumab. If that happens to you, you haven't failed. You've done nothing wrong, and it just means your body can't tolerate it. And you're still getting good treatment. You're getting chemotherapy, you're getting trastuzumab. So we know in the clinical trials that not everybody could stay on it. And what I don't want you to leave with is somehow I'm getting inferior treatment. It's just your body saying, no, thank you. And of course, we would love things to go smoothly. But if you're having diarrhea, that diarrhea can actually be life-threatening. And then the short-term pain outweighs the long-term gain. I've covered a lot. I hope I've answered the question, which is superior? We actually are using both together in many cases. That's not always the case. Trastuzumab can be given with a single agent drug called paclitaxel to people with very low risk cancer. In that case, patients don't get pertuzumab, but most of the time they are given together. I hope this has been helpful. If it hasn't, or if you have questions, just drop them in the comments. Please be kind. We are people too. And thank you so much for watching.